What if I never knew? What if I never... Oh, hey guys, sorry, I'm singing to myself. Hey guys, I got a question for you. What would it be like to live a life that you couldn't remember some of the good things that's happened to you in your past? What if we couldn't remember the good friendships and the loving, sweet moments that we've had and the places that we've seen and all the noises we've heard and all the emotions that have made us who we are? What if we couldn't remember? What if we didn't have our memories? Well, this is a story about a young boy that questions the world around him, and he questions himself, and he wants to know that very question. And what he does with that is the most remarkable story. Thanks for joining me today. Let's get started.
Hey everybody, this is a story called Wilfred Gordon, Mcdonald, Partridge, written by Mem Fox, illustrated by Julia Vivas. Vivas, I hope that's how to pronounce it. There was once a small boy called Wilfred Gordon, Mcdonald, Partridge, and what's more, he wasn't very old either. His house was next door to an old people's home, and he knew all the people who lived there. He liked Mrs. Jordan, who played the organ. He played with Mr. Tippett, who was crazy about cricket. He ran errands for Miss Mitchell, who walked with a wooden stick. He admired Mr. Drysdale, who had a voice like a giant. But his favorite person of all was Miss Nancy Allison Delacourt Cooper, because she had four names, just as he did. He called her Miss Nancy and told her all his secrets. One day, Wilfred Gordon heard his mother and father talking about Miss Nancy. "Poor old thing," said his mother. "Why is she a poor old thing?" asked Wilfred Gordon. "Because she lost her memory," says his father. "It isn't surprising," said his mother. "After all, she is 96. "What's a memory?" asked Wilfred Gordon. He was always asking questions. "It is something you remember," said his father. Excuse me. But Wilfred Gordon wanted to know more. So he called on Mrs. Jordan, who played the organ. "What's a memory?" he asked. "Something warm, my child, something warm." He called on Mr. Hoskin, who told him scary stories. "What's a memory?" he asked. "Something from long ago, my lad, something from long ago." He called on Mr. Tippett, who was crazy about cricket. "What's a memory?" he asked. "Something that makes you cry, my boy. Something that makes you cry." He called on Miss Mitchell, who walked with a wooden stick. "What's a memory?" he asked. "Something that makes you laugh, my darling. Something that makes you laugh." He called on Mr. Drysdale next, who had a voice like a giant. "What's a memory?" he asked.
"Something as precious as gold, young man. Something as precious as gold."
So Wilfred Gordon went home again to look for memories for Miss Nancy, because she had lost her arm. He looked for the shoebox of shells he had found long ago, last summer, and then put them gently in a basket. He found the puppet on strings, which always made everyone laugh, and he put that in the basket. He remembered with sadness the medal which his grandfather had given him, and he placed it gently into the basket. Next, he found his football, which was as precious as gold. And last of all, on his way to Miss Nancy's, he went into the hen house and took a fresh, warm egg from under the hen. Then Wilfred Gordon called on Miss Nancy, and gave her each thing, one by one. "What a dear, strange child to bring me all these wonderful things," thought Miss Nancy. Then she started to remember. She held the warm egg and told Wilfred Gordon about the tiny speckled blue eggs she had once found in a bird's nest in her aunt's. She put a shell to her ear and remembered going to the beach by tram long ago, and how she had felt in her button-up boots. She touched the metal and talked scary of the big brother she had loved who had gone to the war and never returned. She smiled at the puppet on strings and remembered the one she had shown to her sister. She bounced the football to Wilfred Gordon and remembered the day she had met him and all the secrets they had told. And the two of them smiled and smiled because Miss Nancy's memory had been found again by a small boy who wasn't very old either. The end, and we thank you for watching The Kids Headed Your Way. You keep reading to your children if they're too young to read themselves right before they go to bed. Isn't that the tradition we hold? If not during the before they go to bed, then just read to them at any time. It's very good for not only literacy, but just to make the connection between parent and child. You know these things to be true. I don't have to tell you. So let me know. Write in. Let me know how you're progressing. If you've started to read, if you already do read to your children, just any good progress report, I'd love to hear from you. Thank you.
All right, you guys don't want to see my workout schedule. Let's get rid of this. Okay, now you can read this story just as something fun to do and talk about it and design your own lesson plans, but I'm here to show you what I would do, okay? Before you even start the reading the story, I would draw a big circle and then a little circle, okay? And then in the middle circle here, you want to write the word memories, okay? And personally, what I would do is I'm reading the story. I would stop and start the story, and I would have the children I'm reading to fill in this. And you'll see this will make sense as we continue, okay? The next thing I would have is another big circle with a smaller circle. And then in the smaller circle, I would write the word old people, okay? Because this story is partly about the multicultural diversity that we have in the world. And we don't just think about, you know, ethnic groups or religious groups. We also think about people of different ages. And so we're going to learn about different people of that are older. Okay, so.
There was once a small boy called Wilfred Gordon Mcdonald Partridge, and what's more, he wasn't very old either. His house was next door to an old people's home, and he knew all the people who lived there. He liked Mrs. Jordan, who played the organ. He played with Mr. Tippett, who was crazy about cricket. He ran errands for Miss Mitchell, who walked with a wooden stick. He admired Mr. Drysdale, who had a voice like a giant. But his favorite person of all was Miss Nancy Allison Delacourt Cooper, because she had four names, just as he did. He called her Miss Nancy and told her all his secrets.
All right, the next thing I'll put up is, actually, you can go and look at it at the end of the film. This will be the first thing at the end of the film. After the story, after I read the story. And what we want to do is we want to put up the names. Don't you hate that? When you just get through cleaning, the board is still kind of wet, and then you can't draw on it. Like, I really have time to wait here until it dries. We don't have anything but time in life, so what am I arguing about? People in the old home.
the people that Wilfred meets, people in the home. Remember, he lives next door to the people in the, what I call a nursing home. The book didn't refer to it as a nursing home. So we got Mrs. Jordan, right? And then we've got Mr. Hopkins. Hopkins. And then we got a Mr. Tippett. I'm going to put them side by side like that. And then Miss Mitchell. There's so many other little teachable moments you could also have in a read. Like, for instance, teaching kids the difference between Miss and Mrs. and how we use a period there. And then I didn't even use the period. Well, I used it there. So I wasn't consistent. Okay, so now let's keep going. This is Mr. Drysdale. And then last but not least, there's a Miss Nancy. Okay. Now, the reason I put these people in order like this is what you want to do is you can see a progression of going. This is how they get introduced into the story there. And so you can do, you can ask the kids, what are all these people related to? Or why do they have, why, what are they, are there similarities? I mean, what is their, why did the author put them in the story? And how are they different? And how can, are they all going to benefit the lady that our protagonist is wanting to help?
One day, Wilfred Gordon heard his mother and father talking about Miss Nancy. Poor old thing, said his mother. Why is she a poor old thing? Asked Wilfred Gordon. Because she lost her memory, says his father. It isn't surprising, said his mother. After all, she is 96. What's a memory? Asked Wilfred Gordon. He was always asking questions. It is something you remember, said his father.
All right, guys. I would stop the story here if it was me. And then you can look, and this will be the next slide at the end of the video. This, I would make two boxes here. I would draw two boxes. And teachers, take it from me. If you want to say it on paper and you're tired of making copies and people losing stuff, go to Lowe's and you can get some shower stall, the walls for showers, and you can buy a big slab and then get them cut. Lowe's will cut them for you too. And you can make, have little whiteboards. They don't have to be this big, just where you can hold them. And what I do is I pass them out to the kids. They love to draw with beautiful, you know, different colors. And boom, you've got some instant paper that can be erased. And you don't have a bunch of wadding up, throwing it in the trash can. Lots of pros to doing that. So that's a little tip right there. But anyway, getting back to this, you see I done chased a bunny rabbit. I would make some little arrows here. And what you're trying to do now is you're trying to figure out, in the story, Wilfred wants to know what is a memory. Okay? So here's the box, and he wants to know what is a memory. Okay? And as he finds out, you can draw some more boxes over here as to what he comes up with is the answer. But why does he want to know this? Like, why do kids, we know they ask tons of questions. Well, where do those questions come from? Okay? They come from something by what they see or what someone has said to them, and then they create the question in their mind. So that's what you want to plug in here. What led Wilfred to ask this question? Okay, let's keep going.
But Wilfred Gordon wanted to know more. So he called on Mrs. Jordan, who played the organ. What's a memory? He asked. Something warm, my child, something warm. He called on Mr. Hoskin, who told him scary stories. What's a memory? He asked. Something from long ago, me lad. Something from long ago. He called on Mr. Tippett, who was crazy about cricket. What's a memory? He asked. Something that makes you cry, my boy. Something that makes you cry. He called on Miss Mitchell, who walked with a wooden stick. What's a memory? He asked. Something that makes you laugh, my darling. Something that makes you laugh. He called on Mr. Drysdale next, who had a voice like a giant. What's a memory? He asked.
Something as precious as gold, young man. Something as precious as gold.
Okay, now I got the characters back up on the board. You need to go ahead and put the Mr. and Mrs. and Miss and all that. I was in a hurry. And so what we're going to do is talk about, okay, here's some adjectives that describe these people, okay? For instance, what did they say about Jordan? Something, he likes something warm, okay? And then you can talk about that. What does that mean? You can think ahead and ask the kids, well, what do you think that meant when someone says they like something warm? Do they mean coffee? Do they like warm people? People that are polite? I mean, it can mean anything. And so, and also make sure when we're talking to kids to give that wait time, okay? And that can be 10 seconds, 5 seconds, you know, your choice. But you can look out among your students and know when they need you to poke and prod them a little more, okay? Especially if nobody's saying anything. And if a kid does say something, say, oh, I know what warm is. Warm is when they just say something outrageous that is not correct. Make sure that you do not scold them or make them small or make them encourage them. Be appreciative of them just even speaking up. So you never want to say, no, that's not right. Or you and you know this. This is encouragement for you teachers out there. Okay, what is the next one? Tippett. Well, no, we got Hoskins says long ago. Okay, so what does that mean? Okay, from long ago. And then Tippett says something that makes you cry. And so you can talk about that. So you see what I'm trying to do here. We've got all these adjectives up here. And then what is the something as good as gold? And then Miss Nancy, we're going to leave her open, okay? Because maybe we can predict. Maybe you can stop before I get to that part of the story. And you can say, okay, what is warm? What does it mean long ago? What conclusions do you have? Talking about crying, laughing, or someone saying something as good as gold. Then you could stop. I stopped at Nancy, but you can stop up here and you can say, what did we predict based on what we've already read that Nancy might say? And you know, it promotes conversation and conversing with the kids.
So Wilfred Gordon went home again to look for memories for Miss Nancy because she had lost her arm.
Okay, the next thing I would do is draw 5 boxes. Okay, and then what you're going to do is you're going to draw an arrow that shows how we're making the connection, right? And here we're going to talk about Wilfred found out what a memory was, okay? And then that'd be a big box right there. He found out, he solved the mystery of the memory, okay, by people telling him things or what he's seen, heard, and saw, and then here's the answer. And so you can predict it, or you can, after you finish reading that part of the story, you can get the kids to tell you, okay, what in Wilfred's interpretation is a memory.
He looked for the shoebox of shells he had found long ago, last summer, and then put them gently in a basket. He found the puppet on strings, which always made everyone laugh, and he put that in the basket. He remembered with sadness the medal which his grandfather had given him and he placed it gently into the basket. Next, he found his football, which was as precious as gold. And last of all, on his way to Miss Nancy's, he went into the hen house and took a fresh, warm egg from under the hen.
Another reading skill that kids need to possess and have and practice, and you can model it for them, is retention, memory. And so what you're going to do is you could, if you're an artist, you can draw a little basket up here, and you can call that Wilfred's basket. Okay, so we know in the story that he has all these things in the basket, right? You just finished reading that. And so now, boom, you get the kids to remind you of what is in the basket. And so that's just something you could talk about and recall the short-term memory. And also, too, you can open it up for even more discussion. It's like, what in the world has he got? You know, what was his thinking about why he put that in the basket? So.
Then Wilfred Gordon called on Miss Nancy and gave her each thing one by one.
What a dear, strange child to bring me all these wonderful things, thought Miss Nancy. Then she started to remember.
She held the warm egg and told Wilfred Gordon about the tiny speckled blue eggs she had once found in a bird's nest in her aunt's. She put a shell to her ear and remembered going to the beach by tram long ago and how she had felt in her button-up boots. She touched the metal and talked scary of the big brother she had loved who had gone to the war and never returned. She smiled at the puppet on strings and remembered the one she had shown to her sister. She bounced the football to Wilfred Gordon and remembered the day she had met him and all the secrets they had told. And the two of them smiled and smiled because Miss Nancy's memory had been found again by a small boy who wasn't very old either.
Okay, now what we could do, if you wanted to, is we could look at Miss Nancy's basket. Okay? Because she's got all these wonderful things in her basket, and then we want that reminds her, okay? And we just listed that in the last graphic organizer that you made. So you've got and you get the kids to tell you this. There's a warm egg, and so you can say, well, okay, you got a warm egg, got a shell. Get the kids to tell you this now, if that's how you want to do it. Metal. Okay, and then we look at what was the next? Puppet and a football. So we got a puppet and a football. Okay, and so a lot of things you can do here too, as well as after they recall that information to you, you can say, oh, before we get to the end of the story, let's predict. You can teach predicting. It's because something children need to do to be able to predict something. And so we can say, all right, here's the basket. What do you think these things in her basket is going to do for her? Will it do anything for her? Or how will she accept it? What will the story go from here? So, all right. Lastly, we can talk about Miss Nancy's memories. Okay. So. Then you can ask the kids, okay, what about the memories? And ask them what a noun is. You can just say something as simple as that. There's people, places, and things that are nouns, and sometimes ideas. But right now we're looking at people and places. Okay, and so now they can recall Miss Nancy's memories. Who were the people in her memories? Right? And where are all the places that she remembers, okay? Because see, that's the whole gist of the story, is the little boy is getting her to remember, okay? So maybe she has Alzheimer's, and you can teach what Alzheimer's is. But whatever, she has lost her memory, and he is nice, he is nice enough to take time out of his day to say, hey, You know what? I want to help her. I want to give her one more moment of all these memories that are good, hopefully all good and all positive. And so if you want to do it like that, then we can just name. So that's another graphic organizer you can use. All right, you know, hey, you, all right, here we go. We don't have to use all these graphic organizers, but here's just some different examples. Another one, I would put a circle, and I would put Wilfred's name in the middle, okay? And then we can have some bubbles going off of Wilfred, okay? And now we can describe Wilfred. Anything that we want to say, Wilfred is inquisitive here. He's inquisitive, right? He wants to help people. We could say that about Wilfred. We could say whatever you want to say about Wilfred after reading the story to him. And then even you can break that down, you know, into even more here. You can do a lot with this kind of a bubble graphic organizer. All right, I want to keep this graphic organizer up. We have Wilfred in here, right? But we could put Nancy in the middle, and then we could start listing things about Nancy that we recall from the story. So another example. Okay, another thing we can do is you can actually keep this up on the board, keep the one about Wilfred, right? The similarities. Okay, and guess what? All right, these bubbles over here are something that is only related to Wilfred. So that would be different than what Nancy had to offer in the story, right? And so once these also represent something that's just about Nancy, and then that would be different than Wilfred's, right? But what are these? Look at this right here. There's a connection between Nancy and Wilfred. So what we want to call that is similarity. So you can teach differences and similarities to your kids by these simple stories we read. And that is the last graphic organizer that I have. And we appreciate your attention in this. And I'll see you next time. Keep reading. Keep spending time with your kids. Take care. I almost forgot, guys. Hey, there's always something we can learn. The story summary. You always got to do a story. Well, you don't always have to, but I like to do it. And so what we're going to do, we're going to keep in agreement with the little boxes that we've been making. All right? We love boxes, right? They're easy to make, right? Rectangles, whatever, circles. Okay? So this story is about, boom, they put it right there. It could be Wilfred, it could be the old lady, nursing home, whatever the kids think, okay? You know, you get a consensus, so you can just hear from different people, and then you can, yeah, write all kinds of things in this box, because things mean different things to different people, so we don't need to discount anybody's ideas, okay? So, because Tad could say, it's about Wilfred, and then Sally could say, no, it's about Nancy, and another teachable moment is sometimes these kids will argue among one another. And that's when you also, you know what, I should have said this from the beginning, you have to teach first how to respect, teach the kids how to respect each other's opinion, because we're going to do that in our jobs one day, in our social life, and in our marriages. So it's good to teach first, before we even start this business about discussion and people raising their hand or just speaking out loud, is what it means to be respectful when you hear an opinion that's different than yours. Okay, so that's a good teachable moment as well. All right, so this is a story out, boom. Well, in the beginning, okay, so how did this story get started in the beginning? And you can just, you know, they can recall it, okay? And then we're to the middle of the story now. So, what happens next? And then we're also in the towards the latter. Then, so this story is about boom in the beginning, so, then, and then we wrap it up and we say, finally, this is what happened. Okay? This is a good place to play cause and effect. We reap what we sow in life, our actions have consequences, and so we can say. Now, in my mind, just real quick, like I can say, by Wilfred producing good fruit, like his goodness, kindness, you know, being positively inquisitive, this is what happened that led him to make an old lady smile and have an one more day of perfect, sweet, loving memories about her whole life. Because who knows, she could pass away the next day. And so anyway, I've over-dramatized a few things, just had a good time making a quick video, did not turn the camera off and on, didn't edit. I made some mistakes, write in and tell me about all those mistakes, but say it in a nice way, positive way, I can learn from you. See you next time.